Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Dr. Jennifer Cottle.
Well, welcome. I am so excited to be here, and it's so wonderful to see you all, and it's so wonderful to see all of you musicians. You know, the All City organization is an over 70-plus year organization, so this is really, really remarkable to be here tonight. As was mentioned, I'm a physician. I do a lot of television sort of health-type work, but I grew up as a cellist, and I still play cello. And I actually have always felt this way, but I've always felt that music actually helped me become a doctor in a way, helped me become a professional. And so many of the skills I learned as a musician, I feel like I use on a daily basis. So I'm really proud of all the musicians that are here. I'm super excited to hear what they have in store for us tonight. But before we get started, there are a few people who would also like to welcome you here as well. I'd first like to start with Frank Makos, who's the Director of Music Education at the School District of Philadelphia. Welcome, Frank.
Good evening, everybody. We're back for another annual All City High School Music Festival. Are you excited? You definitely should be. This one's going to be a great one. There's so many things to talk about, but I'm not going to say too much. I'm going to let the kids and their instruments and their voices do most of the talking. I'm proud to welcome everybody here this evening on behalf of the School District of Philadelphia. I bring greetings and remarks from Dr. William Height, who couldn't be with us this evening, but is a huge supporter of everything we do, so we thank him for that. I also am proud to represent the Office of Academic Enrichment and Support under the direction of our Chief Academic Officer, Cheryl Logan, who's in the house, and our Deputy Director of Academic Enrichment, Dr. Jack Perry, so we can give them a round of applause. And we have some wonderful partners in the house tonight. I'm going to start with some of our long-standing partners from the Philadelphia Youth Orchestra. We also have some representation from the Curtis Institute for Music. And I'm going to ask you to make some noise because we have some fine young musicians joining us tonight from Musicopia, from the Musicopia String Orchestra. Love to recognize them, if you guys would wave. And for those of you that are enjoying the All City Festival for the first time, you're in for a surprise and surprises and treats. For those of you that are coming back, there's lots of new things happening. It won't look too different and it won't sound very different, but behind the scenes, we're very excited about the work our kids have been doing with one of our new partners, our lead strategic partner and our college and career planning partner, Project 440. You'll hear a little bit more about them tonight, but I want to make sure that we recognize them early. And most importantly, tonight would not have happened without the generosity and the support of the Philadelphia Orchestra. So we're very excited to thank them. If you would please give them a round of applause for me. And I don't know if you heard, but one of the secrets I'll tell you now, there's going to be a finale tonight. We are so excited to debut a world premiere piece commissioned just for these kids. Our composer, John B. Hedges, is in the house. I'm going to ask him to please stand. We'll do it now. We're going to heap love at you all night, so you might as well enjoy it. And couldn't be more thrilled that the piece will be conducted by the Philadelphia Orchestra's own Maestro Yannick. So without further ado, I have the honor of turning it over to the President and CEO of our wonderful presenting partner this evening. Please give a huge warm round of applause. Enjoy the show. Ms. President and CEO of the Philadelphia Orchestra, Allison Vogelmoor. Thank you.
What a tremendous crowd, and welcome one and all. And thank you to Frank. What a tremendous leader he is for all of us. No? Give it up for Frank. I'm so honored to be the president of this great orchestra, but more honored tonight to stand here with all of you for what proves to be a very special evening of incredibly inspiring talent, our young musicians, Philadelphia's musicians. The orchestra's presentation of the All City Festival is a part of our expanding relationship with the School District of Philadelphia. Our mission is to bring the world's greatest music to deserving audiences in Philadelphia and around the world. And nowhere is that more important than here at home with our city students. Our work together with the district will help give young people the tools to succeed and at the same time cultivate the next generation of musical leaders. For the All City Orchestra, we will deploy all of our artistic assets in support of the school district's work with young musicians. Our conductors will help lead them, and our musicians will serve as mentors. And as you heard, our own music director, Yannick Nézet-Séguin, that you'll witness tonight conducting, he wants very much to be a part of the inspiration he feels every time he has met and worked with this group of musicians. He believes deeply in giving back to the next generation, and he benefited from his own teachers and his own upbringing. We're also excited that we'll provide an additional performance opportunity, such as our side-by-side rehearsal on March 19, when All City and our own orchestra musicians will be here right again on stage in Verizon Hall. So these collaborations, we all think, I think all of us, look how full the hall is, that these are the collaborations that are key to the future of our city. School students and their art form, you all inspiring us, quite honestly, is what it's all about. And before I pass on the baton, I do want to take a special moment to recognize our assistant double bass, Joseph Conyers. You all now know him as announced as the leader of the All City Orchestra and certainly the founder of Project 440. We find him an inspiring leader here and in our own orchestra. Thanks also to Dorino Morrow, the leader of the All City Choir, and Dr. Wesley Broadnax, the leader of the All City Band. And perhaps the most special shout out tonight should go to all of the teachers who have tirelessly given service to these students. Give it up for the heroes of our city, our teachers. Thank you all. It's my great pleasure now to introduce Kelly Lee, the Chief Cultural Officer of the City of Philadelphia, a native Philadelphian and a huge supporter of our vast and diverse cultural landscape here in Philadelphia. Bring her on stage. Welcome, Kelly.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you to everyone for coming out this evening for the All City High School Music Festival. And thank you for showing your support for these wonderful student musicians that will perform an amazing program for you tonight. On behalf of Mayor Jim Kenney and the City of Philadelphia's Office of Arts, Culture, and Creative Economy, I am so excited to be here and represent our commitment to the School District of Philadelphia and ensuring that music and arts education is included in all of our children's lives. That's right, I love that. The School District of Philadelphia's All City Music Program is a shining example of how music can bring our entire city together with more than 400 talented students representing 30 public high schools from every neighborhood throughout our city. This year's festival, an outcome of the school district's partnership with the Philadelphia Orchestra, is a model of how organizations and our cultural community can partner and share resources to provide the best opportunities for our youngest artists. The City of Philadelphia is committed to fostering these partnerships to ensure our children's lives are full of arts and music at every stage of their development. We are excited to present you this evening of our city's next generation of musicians, artists, and the future of Philadelphia's creative economy. I am sure you will thoroughly enjoy tonight's program. Thank you.
Okay, well, I think we should go ahead and get started. What do you think? All right, we're gonna go ahead and get started. Please welcome to the stage Philadelphia All City Band Director, Dr. Wesley Broadnax, who's in his third year as conductor of the All City Band. Let's give him a round of applause.
I know that there's going to be a lot of congratulations and thank yous, but I would be remiss if I got off the stage here and did not thank these fantastic students on stage. They're wonderful. I want to thank all of you for your support of these students and your children and for the support of music education. Before we play our last piece, I just want to say that contrary to what your children may have told you, they may have said that this guy standing up in front of them gets all angry at them or whatnot or things, though, but don't believe that. Don't believe that. I always told them, and I do this with all of my students, that when I get excited, that's excitement. That's not hostility. So, okay. The last piece you're about to hear, this is the Festal Scenes, or Dies Festus, from Gloriosa, which is a large three-movement work symphony for a symphonic band. We're only doing the third movement. Yasuhide Ito, a Japanese composer, commissioned this work, performed it, and have conducted it many times. He's the composer of it. It's based on an old chant, Gregorian chant. And as you know, chants during the time are very integral in a lot of church services, particularly the Catholic faith. But this is not based on any religious subject. It's just the basis for the particular piece. We're going to sing in Latin the hymn tune for you so that you get an idea of what the tune is about, and you will hear this in its entirety at the very end of the work. We hope you will enjoy this. Thank you again. This is Yasuhide's Gloriosa.
So wasn't that amazing? I know that our stage is turning over and some students are coming and some students are going, but you know, it's really important to say that there's about 220 teachers, music teachers rather, in the school district. And I have to say, I think teachers make the world go round in a sense, don't you? We definitely have some of the best teachers on the planet dedicating countless hours to our students, and they really make this night possible. So I'd like to continue moving forward. This is, again, a very exciting evening. I think the music that the students are performing is just inspiring. It reminds me of when I was back in school and performing. And one thing I've often say, even to, you know, I'm a family practitioner, I practice in South Jersey, and I see a decent number of high school or middle school students, and I think it's really important to get involved in extracurricular activities. You know, I was able to travel the world. I was able to get scholarship money for college, which I desperately needed. And like I said, I think some of my skills as a doctor have really come from learning music. So the fact that your children are involved in music, I think, is actually one of the best things in the world, and I'm so happy to see it. So we're... So now I would like to move forward a little bit. I'd like to introduce someone named Dorina Morrow, and I'm going to tell you a little bit about her first. Dorina Morrow has taught in the School District of Philadelphia for over 40 years, and she's really been an anchor for All City Choir. You can clap. I think clapping is good. This is great. We see some of our choir students entering right now. You know, members of the All City Choir, actually, they recently sang with the Philadelphia Orchestra at the annual Martin Luther King tribute concert that was held at Girard Choir that was on Martin Luther King Day in January of this year. How many of you either went to the concert, saw the concert, were involved in it with your children, your students in some way? So as you probably know, the choir was actually met with a standing ovation, and this is really not a surprise. After hearing the band that's just performed, I know that the choir is going to be equally outstanding. So I know our students really don't disappoint, and they're filing in right now. Let me ask you, I just have a couple of minutes because I always like to know who's in the audience. How many of you are parents? Can you raise your hand if you're a parent? Yay, parents! Okay, good. And then how many of you are brothers or sisters of someone on stage and you're coming to support your brother or sister? Okay, very good. And then how many of you are just, and I shouldn't say just, but how many of you are friends, faithful supporters, others who have come to, very good. Very, very good. Well, what I'd like to do now is, again, Dorina Morrow, is a lovely lady. I actually just met her backstage. She's got an amazing accolades, and I'd like to bring her to the stage very shortly to conduct her choir. They're a handsome-looking bunch, aren't they? They're a lovely-looking bunch. And so what I'll do now, without further ado, is I'm going to introduce Dorina Morrow, director of the All City Choir, to the stage. Let's give her a big round of applause.
Good evening, everyone. Once again, I stand here humbled by the honor of collaborating with so many fine teachers, administrators, musicians, and of course, the students of the 2016 Philadelphia All City Choir. I always like to do a roll call to acknowledge their work over 4 years. So if you are your first year in All City Choir, would you please stand? Would you acknowledge them, please? Thank you. Now, would you sit, and would the folks who have been in All City Choir for 2 years kindly stand? 3 years, please. And here are the diehards, 4 years. I would like first to thank the Philadelphia Orchestra and their commitment to music education, and the most incredible conductor on the planet, Maestro Yannick. None of this is done without an incredible All-City Choir Committee, and they are Diane Dannenfelser, Jay Fluellen, Christina Blankenship, Cameron Stringham, retired music educators Kathy Flaherty, Tim Flaherty, and William Morrow. I would also like to welcome back Dr. Jack Carr, who was a driving force of All City Choir for so many years and now continues that legacy. A huge thank you to all the teachers and administrators who make this evening a reality. Special thanks to Mrs. Joanne Beaver, the principal of the Philadelphia High School for the Creative and Performing Arts, for her gracious role as host of auditions and rehearsals. Lastly, and most importantly, we would like to thank parents and guardians for these superb vocalists without whom nothing is possible. This is a very exciting year for us as we premiere a piece for choir and orchestra by John Hedges. I am thrilled that John chose poetry by Frances Ellen Watkins Harper as a motivating impetus. The awe, so appropriate words, reinforce what we in All City already know. Music has the power to unite diverse thought, creed, race, socioeconomic background, and gender. Music may be the only speech for those unable to speak for themselves, the old, the young, the sick, and the weary. Music has the uncanny, miraculous ability to hush the discords of pain and wrong. People who unite in a common cause have the power to soothe all these wrongs, and I quote, till war and crime cease. Thank you for support of our work. Thank you for your glorious children. Thank you for hearing and witnessing Frances Harper's 19th century credo. Thank you for believing in music education.
Thank you.
was just amazing. That was wonderful. I wanted to make a note, a lot of the teachers that you saw standing out in front of you that came out at the end, they're the All-City Choir Committee. Teachers in the district who've really helped, they've coached, they've organized, and really practiced with our students to really make all of this possible. So I'm glad that they were able to come out on stage and make their grand entrance and receive applause. So once another applause for the choir. You guys were amazing. Well, you know, this night is actually special for a lot of reasons. We have a number of performances still coming up next. It's actually, you know, I actually think I was realizing this as I came over tonight that this is Super Tuesday. And I was looking forward to Super Tuesday because I was kind of curious about what was going to happen tonight. And I didn't realize it was the night of the concert. So I'm excited that you all are spending your Super Tuesday with us because this is quite super, actually, to be here amongst all of these students. So our orchestra members are taking the stage right now, and I first wanted to say about the orchestra, which is kind of cool. Many of you know that last summer was sort of the debut international tour for the All City Orchestra. They went to Italy, and they had an amazing time and played amazing concerts, and we're really proud of them, and thank you, and welcome home. And there's also a few other things that are very special about tonight. You know, I'm on the board of directors for an organization called Project 440. And that is sort of the brainchild of All City's new orchestra director, Joseph Conyers, who you're going to see in just a moment if you haven't met him. Joseph is actually a friend of mine. We live near one another. We both have a love for classical music. He, of course, is the assistant principal bass of the Philadelphia Orchestra, which is really, really amazing. You know, to get a position in a major symphony orchestra, someone literally has to retire. So to get a symphony position is quite remarkable. And Joseph is not only talented, but he has this amazing aura and sort of spirit about him. And one of the things that he's done is he's the executive director of Project 440, which is a nonprofit organization, of course, that's near and dear to my heart. Project 440 works with young musicians, including many of the ones that you're seeing here, including many of the All City Orchestra students, really to give them tools and teach them skills that will serve them really for the rest of their lives, whether they become professional musicians or follow a different career path. And I'm really proud to be on the National Advisory Board and on the Board of Directors. You know, something I've always said, you know, when I was actually a musician, I remember when I was in high school, around the age of these students here, I actually wanted to be a cellist. That's what I wanted to do. I fell in love with music. I caught the bug. I used to go to all city concerts and perform, and it was what I wanted to do. And what I realize is that music helps you no matter whether you choose to go into music or not. And actually, there's a number of studies out there that show that kids who play music actually do better in school. They have better math and science grades. So again, this is a testament to not only All City, but the students that we have here. So we know that many of our All City students, they participated in a number of seminars that have been offered by Project 440 this year. And that's been made possible by a grant that Joseph Conyers, the director, has received from the Sphinx organization. They presented and participated in a number of seminars. These seminars really are quite awesome because they focus on leadership, they focus on professional skills, on entrepreneurships. Students actually learn how to build their professional toolkit, which is kind of cool, and also problem solving and teamwork skills, which of course we know the importance of those skills never really go away. So this is exciting as the orchestra members are coming on the stage. Oh, look, they're so excited. I used to love playing in orchestra. It used to be so exciting, and I just remember the anticipation I used to feel. I know as parents you all feel that. You're seeing your daughter or your son on stage, and I know you're super, super proud. And the word super keeps coming up, doesn't it? I guess it's a Super Tuesday analogy that keeps happening. Project 440 has a number of chamber ensembles. Actually, this is something that I wanted to mention that's really exciting, I think. After tonight's concert, All City Orchestra members will be encouraged to audition for a brand new chamber series that's being developed especially for them. 10 chamber ensembles will work together with Project 440 teaching artists, Philadelphia Orchestra musicians, school district music teachers, and students from the Curtis Institute of Music to create performances that will delight their audiences. And as you know, Curtis Institute of Music is just down the road in Rittenhouse Square. Curtis Institute of Music has some of the most amazing musicians literally on the planet. And if you didn't know that, I always find that people who don't know that are always shocked, because it's the beautiful building right on Rittenhouse Square, and you can hear the violins and the singers performing in the summertime. Literally, the best musicians from around the world train there. So it's kind of exciting that these chamber organizations are going to be developed. So these interactive performances, they're not only going to bring music to communities, but also encourage the participation of the audience, which of course we love. So this is really important, because I think one of the best things about being musicians is being able to be a role model for other people, for other young people that are coming up in the community. So finally, Project 440 is proud to be the lead strategic planning partner for All City. And in partnership with the School District of Philadelphia, the Philadelphia Orchestra, and other organizations in the city. And I think that's a theme you probably gathered from tonight. Everyone who's coming out is saying how many people they want to thank, all of the people they want to introduce, all of the partnerships, because really it takes a village. I mean, we've all heard that phrase, right? It takes a village, and it does. I mean, this is a whole village here, but you're even a bigger village, and the people backstage who have helped your children, this is part of the village, and it's quite wonderful. So Project 440 really looks forward to a strengthened and vibrant all-city music program in years to come. And something I have to mention, of course, is social media, because social media is so important. Project 440 and the all-city organizations, we're all on Facebook, we're on Twitter, Instagram, I don't know, not so much. I don't think we're on Instagram. No. Okay, thank you. Not so much Instagram. But you can find us on Facebook, you can find us on Twitter, of course through email. So make sure that you like the Project 440 page, that you like the All City page. I've been following it actually. And hopefully if you haven't done that already, you'll do it, because you'll see some of the great articles that have been written about this performance even tonight. Philly.com and the Philadelphia Tribune wrote great articles advertising this concert. So I know I've just been jibber-jabbering along. I know that. So I think it's probably about time for us to get started and hear what we've come here to hear, which is the All City Orchestra. So it looks like the orchestra is getting set. Let's give them a round of applause, because we're so excited. And without further ado, I would like to introduce our concert mistress, who's going to tune the orchestra, and finally Joseph Conyers, the conductor. Year. We're actually going to do a few changes here to the stage. I have a few announcements to make while we get the stage prepared for our next performance. But each year, All City hosts a concerto competition. A concerto competition is basically a solo competition. And a concerto is a piece that is really designed to highlight the instrument or the vocalist who's performing it. So instrumentalists in our program really get to show off our stuff with a concerto competition. And we're so excited that each year, we hold this competition. More and more and more of our young students are competing, and they're really rising to the occasion to challenging some of the most difficult works, because really with concertos, they are usually some of the more difficult works for instrumentalists and vocalists. So, and actually the other thing I should say is it's kind of scary because it's like a solo in front of the orchestra, in front of your peers and things like that. But each year our students really, really shine. So this year, you can actually see a stand coming out. We've got lots of exciting things happening. But I'd like to acknowledge our this year's semifinalists who are going to stand when I call their name. These are semifinalists in the concerto competition who performed amazingly well, and we were so proud of them. We're going to ask you to hold your applause until each name has been called at the end. Musicians, I'm just going to ask you to stand in place on stage from wherever you're seated, okay? We'll start with semifinalists. The first is Lucy Smith, flute. You could stand, please, if you're here. Thank you. There's Lucy. Okay, perfect. We also have Phineas Shapiro, cello. If you could stand, please. We also have Megan Chu, violin. And stay standing, please. Phineas, if you wouldn't mind staying, yes, stay standing, thank you. And then we also have David Heaster, bassoon. We can all give them a round of applause for our concerto competition semifinals. And now I'd like to announce this year's finalists. And once again, I'm going to ask you to hold your applause. Look, if you can't help yourself, it's okay to throw out a little shout out. I'm okay with that. But I'm going to ask you in general to hold your applause till I get to the end of the list. But I'm going to read the finalists now. We first have Veronica Zitova, flute. We also have Kenyobi Simpson Hankins, flute. We have Emmanuel Hondo and Zebediah Coombs, violin and viola duo. We also have Samir Robinson, violin. Let's give them all a round of applause, our finalists for the concerto competition. You may be seated. And now we have our runners-up. I like you guys. This is great. You guys are enthusiastic. You're a good cheerleading squad. This is awesome. So let's keep it going. So let's go on with our fourth runner-up. Fourth runner-up for the concerto competition is Ray Chu, violin. You can applaud. Our third runner-up is Hannah Silverberg, flute. Our second runner-up is Cheyenne King-Bales, violin. And I should also mention Cheyenne, of course, is our concertmaster, so congratulations to her for being our concertmaster. And finally, we have our first runner-up, Dotan Yarden, bassoon. Congratulations, finalists. You may be seated. Thank you. You may be seated. And now, I would like to give a warm welcome to this year's 2016 All-City Philadelphia Concerto Competition winner, 16-year-old Ileana Yang, performing Sassaw Cello Concerto in A minor. Let's welcome Ileana to the stage. Okay. I did want to mention that Eliana does study with Umi Kendall of the Philadelphia Orchestra. And as mentioned, the Philadelphia Orchestra is one of the lead artistic partners for All City, and is one of a few formidable partnerships that we have. So we're very grateful for that. I mentioned Curtis Institute of Music, again, the school that's on the corner near Rittenhouse Square. It's another partner, of course, of Project 440 and the All City Orchestra and All City Festival music groups. Through the annual Curtis Retreat. So really for many years, the Curtis Institute has opened its doors to All City students for a day filled with coachings and master classes and guest conductors. And this year, we're actually pleased to have the music director of the Houston Symphony, Maestro Andres Orozco Estrada, lead this year's side by side with the students of Curtis. And I have to say, as a musician, honestly, it is very, very rare. And it is such a blessing that your students are able to study with world-renowned musicians. I grew up in the great state of Iowa. Yes, Iowa. In the middle of the country, but we didn't necessarily have access to all this amazing music and the talent that your students have access to. And the fact that they've got partnerships with the Philadelphia Orchestra, with Curtis Institute of Music, really it's unheard of and it's unparalleled. So it's really quite wonderful. So moving forward, Musicopia is also one of the fiscal agents for the institution that really supplies the All City organization with administrative resources. Can we give a round of applause for all of the partners that we have, because we really do appreciate them. And now, without further ado, we're going to keep this show moving. Next, we're going to introduce back Joseph Conyers for the Sassau Organ Concerto Finale featuring Michael Stairs on organ. Please welcome Joseph Conyers. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that was amazing orchestra, of course, as always. So if you weren't excited already, you're just going to be more excited because we're coming on to the grand finale. But the exciting thing about that is not the fact that it's a grand finale, the fact that all the students actually get to play together, which I'm really excited to hear. Just a couple of things first, though. Remember, the choir, just like the band and orchestra, we have a number of committees made of school district teachers that are the glue that really helps hold our programs together. I've said it before, it's like a village, you know, it's a big, big village. And we appreciate all of our teachers who are helping. And at this time, I'd really like to recognize the committees of both the band and the orchestra. So if we can give a round of applause to our band and orchestra committee members, I know they're going to be coming on out. Perfect. Big round of applause. Band and orchestra committee members. Thank you very much. Let's keep clapping. Let's keep clapping. There we go. Keep it coming. So we're about to prepare for tonight's grand finale, and there's going to be a few changes coming to the stage. One thing I just have to say about teachers and about the committee members you just met, you know, honestly, for many of your children, for your friends, your family, whoever's on the stage, these are the people, in addition to you all, these are the people that are inspiring them. These are the people that are with them every single day, that they aspire to become, that they aspire to perform like, to play like, to be like. And I remember growing up, my music teachers were still people that I revere to this day. In fact, my cello teachers all through the years, I still call them at least once a year and catch them up on how I'm doing. Because in some ways, teachers, many times, are often like family members. So I really, really thank all of the teachers and the committee members are here because I know exactly how big of an influence they have on your child's life and just how hard they work. So we're getting set up here. What I'd like to do now is as we prepare for tonight's finale, I'd actually like to invite to the stage the composer of the work that you're about to hear. Now, the work that you're about to hear is called Promise of a City, and it's written by John B. Hedges. It's a world premiere, which is particularly exciting. It means that you all are the first, and I, we're the first person to hear this, which is very exciting. And it's written specifically for tonight's performance, which makes it even that much more special and exciting. So I would like to invite Mr. John B. Hedges, if I can find him. Come on down. Very good. Welcome. So I am delighted to have this gentleman, this composer next to me. And while everybody's getting set up, we're just going to do like a little meet and greet, like a little interview, okay? Like inquiring minds want to know. So first of all, I have a question that's not on my script because I just want to know.
All right.
It's nothing scandalous. It's nothing, or you'll be able to answer it.
Fair enough.
But I'm curious, how old were you? It's like a two-part question.
All right.
How old were you when you started composing? And how old were you when you said, aha, this is what I want to do with my life?
Well, it's a great question. According to my mom, I was one. honestly, I had done, when I was in middle school or high school, I started to kind of dabble in it. And it really wasn't until college, until my last semester at, my last year at college, I had wanted to write music, but didn't really know how. And I told my professor, who was at Penn, Jay Reese, and he sat me and I said, what do you want to do? And I said, I wanted to write music. And he told me, I wish you would have told me this like 3 years ago. It would have been great. We could have been working on it. But it's never too late. It's never too late to start. It's never too early to start. Yeah.
That's exciting. So we have your piece on the program, and I think one of the neat things about having you here tonight, are you excited? I'm really excited.
I'm so beyond excited.
Okay, because I'm really excited.
It's intense.
I hope you're as excited as I am, because I'm super, this is awesome.
The only person maybe more excited is the woman sitting next to me. We bonded earlier. You know, I'm talking about you.
You can wave if you want to. Okay, so this is my last question, because I know we're here for the kids and we're about ready to go, but since we have the composer right in front of us, let's get a snapshot of what inspired you with this piece. What should we be listening for? What is this about? Give us a couple sentence gestalt idea of the insight into this piece.
You got it. So I've always thought of Philadelphia as a promise. It was a promise that was made by William Penn to be a place of tolerance, to be a city unique, unique in the entire world, of a place where people could come from different backgrounds and live together in peace. And it's something that we are proud of, but we struggle to live up to. But there's that promise there. And when Joseph Conyers commissioned me to write this, I thought to myself, I don't know that there's any place that better embodies that promise made real than on this stage tonight with All City. That's pretty much it.
Well, that is beautiful, and it's quite inspiring. So I just want to thank you, John B. Hedges, so much for
this piece.
We're looking forward to hearing it. Thank you so much.
Me too. All right. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Okay, so we are honored, we are thrilled, we are humbled not only to have our composer in the audience, but also to welcome to the stage a very, very special guest. I personally, well, you know, I've been excited this whole night, I know, so I'm still excited, but I'm particularly excited also to see our next guest. He's dynamic, he's passionate, and he's an inspiration to any audience and any artist that he comes in contact with. I'm so excited to introduce you to conduct our All City Festival concert for the second year in a row, the music director of the Philadelphia Orchestra, Yannick Nizet-Segon. Please welcome.
No.